Hi, I'm Anne-Marie Concepcion from InDesign Secrets. I want to show you today how simple it is to mix page sizes in a single InDesign document. Now, the very first thing you should do, though, is check with your print provider, because they might, for some reason, not want you to do that. It hasn't been my experience, but when you export to PDF, all the pages will come out at the correct size, whichever size that you said. The different page sizes will appear, but there might be a print provider who would prefer that you create two separate PDFs. So check with them first. But today, what we're going to do is take a look at this document, which is Cuba Today, Pictures and Text from a trip that I took to Cuba. You can see it's just a short pamphlet. And down here on pages 6 and 7, I have a full spread image. And say, for example, that this image was even wider and I had the budget to add a gatefold page, like a half-width page here, to include the entire image if I wanted to. So how do I do that? Well, first, before you add a page to a document, you need to turn off allow document pages to shuffle. This is only for facing pages documents. Otherwise, InDesign won't let you create a 3-page spread. So I'll turn that off. And now I'm just going to drag a page from the right-facing master and tuck it in here just to the right of page 7. See that bracket? That means it's going to glue itself right next to it. And then target the page that you want to change the page size for. So double click just that one page that's targeting the page. You can see that right now it just came in at the default measure, right? What is the default measure? Well, go to the File menu and go down to Document Setup. And this will tell you the current measure. It's 6 inches by 9 inches. So I want to create a page that is 3 inches by 9 inches. How do I do that? There's two places. One is at the bottom of the Pages panel. There's an icon here, Edit Page Size. And you can choose one of these built-in page sizes, or you can choose Custom. And under Custom, I'm going to make my own new page. I'm going to call it Gatefold. And I want it to be 3 inches by 9 inches. And I'll add it to the list. So you see, these are other ones that I've done in the past. So there's Gatefold. And I want to click OK, and now this page changes to 3 inches by 9 inches. I have my gatefold page. There's 3 pages on this document. Now I'm going to undo and show you the other way to change a page size. Oops, once again, make sure that only that page is targeted, and then choose the page tool, which is right here, this guy right underneath the direct selection tool. And when you have the page tool selected, you see that the control panel goes into page tool mode, and there's handles around the targeted page. Here you can drag to resize that one page. And I'm watching the control panel here to make sure that I get the correct width. Now the problem with the page tool is that this is just for, you know, testing. If you actually want to change the page size, you have to hold down the Option or Alt key as you drag, or actually, you know, before you let go of the mouse. So let me get it to 3 inches. Okay, I'm getting there. So this is kind of like not my favorite way, you can tell. All right, come on. There you go. Okay, got it. I could have just chosen Gatefold because that same menu appears here. So there you go. Those are 2 different ways to change the page size. Now let's go ahead and export this to PDF, and we'll just export it right to the desktop and view the PDF after exporting. And so we'll see that third page, that Gatefold page in Acrobat. And let's scroll down. So here's all of our 6 by 9 pages. And then there's our little page, our gatefold. Some of the bleed has appeared on this page, but that's something that you would normally fix, of course. Or I would have brought the picture all the way out to the edge of this page, too. All right, so very simple. 2 different ways to change the page size of any page in an existing InDesign document. Hey, I hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles, to listen to our podcast, and to download a free sample issue of our monthly magazine called InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.